Hey everyone, it's Movie Lover 120 here, and I'm here with episode 9. Oh, yeah, episode 9. Episode 10 of my Christmas movie reviews, and that's going to be for two movies. First, where it started off as an animated special and then turned into a live action movie. And that's going to be for both the first two adaptations of How the Grinch Stole Christmas. So, guys, for those of you that obviously do know, How the Grinch Stole Christmas was a Dr. Seuss book. It was considered very phenomenal. And it's considered one of Dr. Seuss's greatest books. For those who don't know, also do know, Dr. Seuss was a big inventor of our childhoods. And it touched the hearts of many. And he had great morals and messages with his books, and his books were very creative with rhyming and creative with colors. And they were such great childhood reads. So, of course, some of his books got turned into animated TV specials around the 60s. And of course, what is probably considered the best of the animated specials was the Chuck Jones special of The Grinch. Yeah, this one is the one that gets the most reruns on TV every year. Pretty much every Christmas. It's a fun special to watch just every holiday season. And it's considered the best of all the adaptations. It's about a creature named the Grinch who lives in Whoville, who tries to take away Christmas from the townsfolk of Whoville below his mountain hideaway. And that's the plot for both versions. And here's why the 1966 one rocks so much. It's 100% faithful to the original book of the same name. It's got the glorious traditional cell animation that fits the Dr. Seuss tone very well. Some decent vocal performances, like Boris Karloff was great as the Grinch. Memorable and catchy songs such as Welcome Christmas and of course You're a Mean One, Mr. Grinch. And it's a very important message too. Maybe Christmas doesn't come from a store. Maybe Christmas perhaps means a little bit more. Which I wish more people would realize that Christmas isn't just about gifts. Although the principles are Christian, at least the themes here are broader and could be applied to material culture and religion in general. Some uplifting and emotional moments, such as the Grinch learning the true meaning of Christmas and gives all the presents back to the Whos. And Dr. Seuss was even involved in making this special, and some very outstanding direction from Chuck Jones. And there's these added rhymes written exclusively for the special, which are perfect ad-libs. Now, of course, there are some bad qualities, but this one has the less bad qualities. Some kind of animation errors, like when the Grinch would sneak down the chimney, his hat kind of turns green for a few frames. And even though it's explained why the Grinch hates Christmas, how would it make sense for him to hear what's happening and see what's happening if he lives very, very far away from the Whos? Like the other four specials that come later, the narrator, including the Grinch, doesn't know what was written in the original book word for word. But other than that, I think it's definitely one of the best, probably one of the best Christmas specials, I think second best, behind Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, which is by Rankin Bass. But now that I've talked about the 1966 special, I'm actually going to be talking about next, of course, around 34 years later, there was a live-action movie starring Jim Carrey as the Grinch and directed by Ron Howard. And I know it's very infamously hated by Nostalgia Critic, since he often reviews it and often mentions it when he does negative Dr. Seuss reviews, and when he bashes the Dr. Seuss movie adaptations. He usually is not afraid to attack this adaptation of The Grinch the most. And this live-action movie was released in November 17, 2000, and how was it? Well, it's good, in my opinion. I know a lot of people hate it, but there are some kind of detractors it has. Well, there's people that consider it a good Christmas movie, and there's some people that consider it a horrible take on Dr. Seuss. But honestly, even if it's not like good like the Chuck Jones special, I still consider it a very freaking masterpiece. Masterpiece, and I still watch it every Christmas.
However, it is certainly better than this shit.
Yeah, especially compared to that film, which I've already done an angry review on. But anyway, back to The Grinch. What are the good qualities of this version? Well, Jim Carrey's hilarious in the movie and portrays the character perfectly. In addition, his makeup and costume are fantastic, but however, the makeup used on Carrey was very thick, and putting it on took so long that it nearly drove him mad, so he had to bring in a CIA operative to train him to remain in calm while it was being applied. Arnhart even showed solidarity towards Carrey by dressing up like the Grinch to cover him. Carrey was able to be very expressive in his facial expressions, even with the makeup on. His soundtrack performed by Lake composer James Horner is spectacular. The source material is well-structured. Some decent visuals. The Grinch's backstory is well-handled, even if it is a bit cliché. I mean, giving the Grinch a backstory to flesh out the origin of his hatred to Christmas is kind of a good idea. Since the original book doesn't really mention, and neither does the special, why the Grinch hated Christmas in the first place. He just opted to steal Christmas out of spite towards the end of the news. The You're a Mean One song is still catchy, and actually Jim Carrey's a pretty good singer at it. Well, and while a bit mean spirit times, there are occasionally funny moments here and there, like the scene when the Grinch is at his home, he yells these echoes, and when he yells that I'm an idiot, there's this echoes out, you're an idiot, and stuff. And where the baby version of the Grinch bites off Santa's head off a plate and says, Santa, bye-bye. Since, technically, the plate was a Christmas cookie to him. The scene where the Grinch named Boosie hates outside his home. And once the Grinch pulls off his tablecloth and keeping all the cards on the table perfectly, only for him to go back and knock them off himself. And even the Grinch actually even brings up a good point on how all the Who's in this version think Christmas is just all about gifts and stuff, even though it's not. And there are still innuendos in this film, but they're definitely not as bad as the crap in the hat. Now for the bad qualities. Yeah, there are a lot. The film can get too dark for children. Yeah. Since some thought it was political to put an anti-consumerist message in the film. And the Grinch, especially with all the Who's in general, are very horrifyingly designed. They basically just look like ordinary human beings performed by live performers because of it. And Whoville's not even appropriately represented. It doesn't look like the original work suggests this. Most of the shots are even dirty and smoky since the entire town were on fire. And, what else? The Who's even behave very unlike their book counterparts as well. Well, in the original book and Chuck Jones special, they don't care about their presents being gone. They still celebrate Christmas even with nothing around. They hold their hands, they sing together, and they love one another. Even the Grinch and don't even care that he took their stuff and even forgive him straight away. So wait, they're actually very good. Very good in that one. They know what Christmas is really about though. In the book and special. Here, they're the opposites. They are basically corrupt, selfish, ignorant, self-absorbed, and cold-hearted, and they're even cruel to the Grinch. Even before he even steals Christmas. They're actually such assholes to him. And they make the Grinch seem like a hero and make him have a good reason to ruin their Christmas and basically give them karma on it. There's way too many characters that are very one-dimensional and likable, except for Cindy Lou and her family, Martha and the Grinch. And the film gets way too mean-spirited at times. Like, there's this one scene where where when the Grinch first meets Cindy, he actually does save her, but he then regrets and denies doing so. Like, there are still a number of inappropriate jokes and innuendos that are not only unfunny, but don't fit in a Dr. Seuss movie. Well, some people get really mad over this, especially Nostalgia Critic, where Grinch has the antagonist kiss the butt of his dog, Max. But it's kind of funny for what it is, and I would definitely take that over something like Dirty Ho. And it kind of goes on for too long, like 105 minutes, but despite those criticisms, I still think it's a fine movie. It's not as good as the Chuck Jones special, but it's a fine Christmas movie for what it is, as long as you don't compare it to the book or try to heavily compare it to the special. It's somewhat of a better movie that way. Now, here's how I would rank both these films.
I am going to give the Grinch 1966 version a 10 out of 10. And as for the 2000 live-action movie, I am going to give that movie a 7.5 out of 10.
And that sums up my reviews for both the Grinch movies. So, you're wondering what's going to be the next episode. Well, it's not really about Christmas for this next movie, but it's got a Christmas setting. So, and a lot of people call it a Christmas movie as a joke, since, well, it's set during Christmas, even though it's not actually about Christmas. And, of course, it's an action-themed movie from the 80s. Yes, Die Hard, the first movie, is going to be the next episode. But until then, that'll be our first review. Guys, thank y'all for watching. If you'd like to see more of that, don't forget to like and subscribe to Movie Lover 120.